Today we begin our third series on oil and gas, but before we move forward, we'd like to look back on series two. Much of the debate this year has been dominated by the seemingly endless battle between Kosmos Energy and the government of Ghana.
The whole issue has become politicized, and which is terrible.
You think so?
It is. It has been politicized. I mean, we've heard a lot of brouhaha about this Kosmos Exxon, you know, deal, for example, and the way the government is strong-arming and intervening and sort of to abrogate deals, for example, gives Ghana a very, very bad name and image abroad.
But what are you saying, that when a government comes into power and is not unhappy, it must do nothing with what has happened
before? That's not what I'm saying. You know, when a government is not happy with a particular deal, the government can take the recourse and take that particular issue to court.
Right.
Rather than acting somewhat arbitrarily. Yeah.
And you also think this is arbitrary? That's the point.
That is the point. You see, this is the message that it sends to investors. And, you know, it sort of sends a very cold chill down their spine in terms of, you know, that look, you know, they can come here and sign a deal, but then, you know, come in a change in government, you know, that deal could be off, you know. That is not the kind of signal you want to send to investors, okay? Sure, the government can have some qualms about certain particular deals, for example, but the government should take these particular misgivings to court and let a court decide. This is what is meant by the rule of law. Mm. And contracts must be obeyed and must be followed if we want to attract foreign investors here. But look it, we don't have the technology to exploit the oil, okay? And that's why it's necessary to have foreign firms come in.
Professor of Economics George Ayite is known to speak his mind. While he acknowledges the need for foreign investors, he cautions about the choice of partners, the Chinese in particular.
In the past, we were exploited by the West, we were colonized, we were enslaved by the West, okay? Now, because the West is an enemy of China, we are embracing China wholeheartedly, as if the enemy of my enemy must be my friend. Mm. It is nonsense, okay? Now, we should remember this. We should learn from our own history. Every foreign entity that comes to Africa comes here to pursue their own interests. The Chinese don't come to Africa because they love black people so much. They come here to pursue their own interests. And that is what we should wake up to, okay? I'm not saying they shouldn't come.
Yeah.
Okay?
So what is there to wake up to? If people can come.
But when they come here, they must play by the rules, okay?
Everybody must play by the rules.
Everybody must play by the same rules, okay? The rules are that, you know, the deals that you sign with various African governments must be transparent, okay? And not that you come here and you secure a deal by building presidential palaces, you know, for the president. We don't want any company, any foreign entity, to pay bribes to secure contracts.
Activist and local firebrand Kwesi Pratt has been very vocal on the issue of foreign investment and national interest. He sees it this way.
We are running an economy in which the people of Ghana work for the benefit of others other than themselves.
For 50 years as a nation.
In fact, more than 50 years.
And we continue to do that.
If you see the neo-colonial state as a continuation from classical colonialism and also from the transatlantic slave trade and all of that, then it's for hundreds of years we have produced for the benefit of others. And we've not been able to utilize our natural resources to cater for the interest of our people, to meet the aspirations of our people and so on.
So now that's we have the all the lessons. This extractive industry, for example, this is a gold mining country. Many years of gold mining experience, of partnering foreign companies, of negotiating and so on. Surely we must have some knowledge that we can apply to oil and gas so that we begin to benefit from our natural resources.
I'm afraid we need a new kind of experience, which is substantially different from the experience we've had in gold mining and diamond mining and so on. Mm. You just need to go to the mining, you know, communities to see the level of poverty, the level of degradation, the environmental destruction and so on, and to tell yourself that this is not the way to go. We've got to have a new paradigm for the exploitation of national resources.
Whatever your views on the pros and cons of mining, here are some facts about what Ghana gets from its oil. Between taxes, royalty, and additional oil entitlement, the country is said to gain over 50% of the income. But the debate rages on. I spoke to the advisor to the Ministry of Finance, Dr. Joao Makuntufo. Sometimes people say we are being cheated. remember that we are, all of this is against the backdrop of an oil mining industry, which for many reasons, and even that has to be debated properly, is considered not to have done anything for Ghana. So that's the notion I have in mind. I want your view on that. That's what I mean by, are we okay? Is that the arrangements okay? Will we get a fair amount of this?
I think for starters like us, offshore, very expensive, very risky, we've done well. Of course, we can always do better. And you can see in some of the recent agreements that we are not taking 5% royalty. We are asking for...
I see more.
More.
Increase
yeah,
royalty.
Okay. So, given the nature of the industry, if you're a small beginning player, you have to play it smart.
Which means don't ask for too much from the start.
Yeah, because you may not get anyone to come and help you. What the Tolo and the Cosmos and those have done is they have to put us out there. And people are there for there's a greater demand for opportunity for exploration.
So it makes sense for them to have gotten maybe a good deal. And then now that other people are coming, the industry is now, everybody knows about it.
Yeah, I think it's a fair deal.
Although not everyone agrees, over 50% seems a substantial sum. I guess the real issue is what we do with the revenue. Vitus Azim of the Ghana Integrity Initiative sees it this way.
There are three basic things that anybody or any country, even a family, needs to have in place if they want to, if they're working in the best interest of the members of that group. Transparency, participation, and accountability. You must be open in whatever you do. So, for example, in the case of a government, you should provide your citizens with comprehensive, accurate, reliable, timely information about the affairs of the state. When you are able to do that, then the citizens are able to participate in the decision-making process because they understand the issues, they can contribute. So that you refine the policy that you want to put in place. And once they have contributed and they know what to expect, they are now in a position to hold you accountable if you don't do things the right way. So you need that triangle. Transparency, participation, and accountability. If you are able to do that, and if Ghana is able to ensure that these three things actually take place in this country, we are going to derive maximum benefit from our oil fine. But if we don't do that, if, for example, in the agreements that we are making, if we keep it, if the public of the government officials keep the agreements to their heart or to their chest.
And do not show us
and
what's
do not
in
show
it.
Us.
That's not transparency.
Yes, so that we cannot see the loopholes.
That's not transparency.
Yes, it's not
so transparency. So tell me. So at the moment, are the petroleum agreements that the government of Ghana through the GNPC is signing with these companies, are they available for you to look at?
They are not available.
So there's no transparency.
For the public.
That's what, so there's no transparency.
They are not being subjected to public discussion. Yes. So there's no transparency, there's no participation.
So we've already started without
transparency. So it becomes difficult to hold them accountable.
Back in a moment.
Water from the bosom of nature, the real natural mineral water, undergoes high quality and good filtration. Check the looks, and stylish and trendy. Fresh air and cool, not a mean of water, deep, deep down from the bowels of my nature. It's fresh and cool and nice. The real, not a mean of water.
Get your refreshment from the real natural mineral water. Safina, the real natural mineral water.
Safina. Are you in need of credible and relevant business information to make vital decisions? Or do you wish to reach Ghana's upmarket business and consumer segment with your product and services? Subscribe to and advertise in Business and Financial Times today, Africa's leading source of credible and relevant business information. For enquiries, contact 021-785-3667 or visit www.thebftonline.com.